Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Welcome to Sikhi in Numbers, and today we're going to be talking about free. In Gurmukhi, free, thin, is written like this. Firstly, we have the free modes of Maya. We may be oblivious of it, but every day in our Nitnim, in Japji Sahib and Anand Sahib, we mention these free guns. Tehi guni sansar pram sutta, sutya ren vihani. Sri Anand Sahib Ji gives us the teaching that we are all sleeping in the free modes of Maya. Maya is the name of the energy that creates the whole universe. In a commonly cited example, Maya is described as a dependent female. Like a female cannot give birth to a child without a man, in that same way Maya was useless. This dead entity Maya eventually met with Akal Purakh Vaheguru. Akal Purakh Vaheguru gave her his energy through which she was able to now become fertile and conceive the whole universe. The first part of this conception is the free gunas, the free modes. This strange and miraculous occurrence has been described in Sri Japji Sahib. The pangti that you are having darshan of, Ika Mai, Ika refers to one God and Mai, the union with Maya. This brought about Tin Chile Parvan. Tin Chile refers to the free modes of Maya. At any one time, one of these three modes is more influential over us. Satogun causes us to help others, Rajogun makes us selfish, and Tamogun is destructive. In this table, you can see some of the attributes of the three guns. In one analogy, Tamogun has been described to be like a block of ice, static and restrained. Rajogun like flowing water that has no direction, and Satogun as steam that can be channeled as power and energy. In one arth of this pangti, Ik Sansari refers to Rajogun Brahma, Ik Pandari, the sustainer that helps the universe, is Satogun Vishnu, and Ik Lai Di Ban, the one that brings the world to an end, is Tamogun Shiv. We'll visit that again. Next, we have the free loks, the free pavans, the free houses of the universe. Matlok, Patalok, and Swarglok. Ouch, that looks painful. Next, we have the three types of Tap, disease. The first is an Adhyatmik Tap, a physical or a mental illness. The next is known as an Adibhut or Adibhautik Tap. These are the pains that are attained from other beings, whether they are humans, animals, or even insect bites. Finally, we have an Adidevik Tap. Adidevik Tap is caused by weather. You may have heard a Granthi Singh read this just before the Ardas. Tine Tap Nivaran Hara Dukhanta Sukras. That refers to Vaheguru's ability to remove us of all free taps. Gurbani refers to the ancient Indian Sanatan belief in 30 crore devte, 330 million gods. Not only that, but there are additional 9 crore devinya. But luckily for us, we only have to learn about the Trimurti, the three most important gods, Brahma, the creator, Utpatti, Vishnu, the sustainer that has the job of Palana, and Shiva, who has the job of Leta, or to bring the world to an end. Their respective wives are known as the three Shaktis. Shakti means power. Parvati, the wife of Shiva, is the goddess of power, Shakti. Lakshmi, the god of Maya, fortune and wealth. Saraswati, the wife of Brahma, is in charge of knowledge, Vidya. As Sikhs, we don't worship them. And we recognize, and even the Hindu scriptures recognize, that they have three weaknesses. Asahita, which is hankar, Khyata, which is jealousy, and Kinta, which is fear or dar. At number 7, we have the free freeze. So in this, firstly, we have the free actions, pap, upashana and hinsa. Hinsa is violence, pap is sin and upashana is worship. And each of these three can be carried out by man, vach or karam, either mentally or by speech or through actually action. Taking hinsa, violence, as an example, thinking violently of hurting someone is hinsa through the man. Verbal aggression, making threats to kill someone or hurt them, are forms of hinsa through vach, through speech. Then obviously practical violence, hinsa, is hinsa in karam. Two polar opposites, pap, how you sin, and upashana, how you worship, can also be performed via man, bachan or karam. There are also said to be three types of karam, pralabdh, sanchit karam and kiriman karam. Pralabdh are the karams of our previous life that we bring over into this life. Pralabdh is very important and it impacts at least three things: the family which we're going to be born into, how long we're actually going to live, and in that duration our life experiences, how rich or poor, how sad or happy. This is a predetermination by pralabdh. Our sanchit karam are the accumulation of our actions of our previous lives. These are still yet to be reaped. Thirdly, we have kriyaman karam. These are the karams, the actions that we are currently engaging in that will lead to results in the future. You can learn more about this from Pai Daya Singh Sahib's examples in the 41st adhyay of the Panjami Rut of Sri Guru Pratap Suraj Granth. The example of the archer is a famous one. In yogic science, Ida, Pingala and Sukmana were three nerves that were very important for spiritual development. These are mentioned in Gurbani, as you can see. Ida, Pingala aur Sukmana teen basahe ikthai. However, the Shabad refers to a more spiritual, deeper and intricate meaning. Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahibji's Bani mentions that there are three stages in life. Baal, Juwani aur Birdfun, teen avastha jaan. Our academics have cited three types of anand or pleasure. The first is vishyanand. This type of bliss comes from sin, physical experience, and it is short-lived. Number two is bhajanand, that is brought for some time according to our spiritual capability. And the third is true and everlasting oneness with God, brahmanand, the pleasure that that oneness of experience brings. Sri Guru Amar Das Sahib Ji tells us, Anand Anand Sab Ko Kahe Anand Gur Te Janiya, that this type of bliss is only found through the true Guru. In Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji and in Dasam Guru Granth Sahib Ji, Tribeni, the confluence of three rivers of India, are referred to. These are Ganga, Jamuna and Saraswati. Mal, Vikheb and Avaran. These are the three faults that do not allow us to see ourselves as the true form of Akal Purakh Vaheguru. Mal is the filth of previous janams and this janam. This is removed by Nishkam Karam Seva. Vikheb is restlessness of the mind. This is removed by performing Simran. And the veil of ignorance is taken away by listening and applying Guruji's teachings. Jap is the first instruction of Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji and the name of the first Bani. It teaches us that as Sikhs, our duty is to meditate, to perform Jap. In the Taksal Arth Pelli Puthi, Sant Kartar Singh Ji explaining Jap tell us that in the Sanskrit texts of India, there are three types of Jap. Number one is Vachik Jap. Vach Jap is doing abhyas out loud, clearly hearing what actually you're reciting. Number two is Upans Jap. In Upan's job, the person that is reciting through their lips. They're reciting so quietly in their mouth that even a person sitting next to that person wouldn't be able to make out what this person is saying. The third type is Manas Jap. Manas Jap is doing Simran through the mind, mentally reciting and doing Abhyas of Shabad, Gurmantar, Mool Mantar, whatever it is that you are doing Abhyas of. Penultimately, we have three sadhans, Sravan, Manan, Dhyasan. You may have heard of these in the Japji Sahib Katha. Listening, accepting and applying Guruji's teachings in our lives. At number 15, we have the three bodies, the sthul or the physical sarir, the sukham sarir that is inside the subtle body of the physical body, and the karan sarir that goes with us after we die and then comes back with us as we are reincarnated. Thank you for watching Sikhi in Numbers. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe to us on social media.